So all I'm going to do is just narrate the footage that you're currently watching. The clicker had just gone off, indicating that we probably had a fish taking the minnow. So basically what we did is we used the trolling motor to get closer to where the bobber was. The bobber was still on top of the water, so we had an idea where the fish was. And upon getting closer, we were in relatively shallow water, and we actually saw the fish with the sucker in its mouth. Now, it's important to note that you want to make this process of setting the hook as quickly as possible. So getting on top of the fish very quick is very key, but you can actually see the fish on the footage faintly. And to me, it looked like it had the sucker in a good spot. So I go ahead and set the hook very hard, and you'll see I fight the fish for a little bit. And right here, it'll end up coming off because it didn't have the harness in its mouth. Now you can see the sucker is still alive. It's actually kicking around. And instead of like pulling the sucker out, for some reason, I just decided to let some line out. But this is cool. Muskies are aggressive in general, but they're very aggressive in the fall. So if you the same thing happens to you, don't count yourself out, because you'll hear me, I say,
that's him right there, isn't it?
And as soon as I point at it, this happens.
Black line.
Tail.
It looks like a fish.
Oh yeah, he's... It comes right back for the sucker minnow, giving us a second shot at the fish. Now, here is where I guess people would be controversial as to what we do. Now, keep in mind, we can see the fish. We are in less than 5 feet of water. We can see the fish the entire time. It just grabbed the sucker minnow, and instead of rushing to set the hook right away again, we actually saw that the fish had the sucker minnow by the tail. There was no hooks near the tail, so the opportunity of being in shallow water allows us to watch this fish for a very long time. This entire video, I think, is 8 minutes of us watching this fish. Now, if we didn't see the fish, you would never want to do that, because you never know if that fish is going to swallow the entire sucker minnow, swallow your harness. It's not good for the fish. You're probably going to kill the fish. But like I said, we were fortunate enough to be able to see this fish the entire time. So I'll kind of speed it up here. And you can just see we're right on top of the fish. It doesn't spook away. A lot of times you can see the fish on the video and it just has the sucker by the tail. It finally kind of started to move the sucker around in its mouth. I told my friend Caleb that I think I got a good enough chance, so I set the hook backwards.
I think I might be able to get him.
And the fish still comes off again. Yes. But luckily we got it in the net. Just goes to show you, you know, people, the first time I uploaded this footage, people were like, oh, you let that fish eat the minnow for way too long. You can literally watch, though. I mean, it didn't have hooks. It still came off. This wasn't a very big fish. I'll put a picture on screen right now. It was just about a little 37 or 38 incher. But again, the process will remain the same. Using a sucker minnow is a very fun thing to do. And I hope this video helped either newcomers out or people that are just kind of getting into sucker minnow fishing. With that being said, I'll see you guys in the next video.